Hello, I'm David Brown from the Solidworks training team. This video presents a project that you can use to hone your Solidworks skills and is easy to make if you have a basic 3D printer. You can use this on board game night to track things like action points remaining, how many turns have passed, lives you have left, etc. This simple counter could also be used for a variety of other things like keeping track of the score at a kid's sporting event, or carry in your pocket to keep track of your golf score. You may need more than one if you golf like I do. This video will demonstrate my approach to this design using master model technique in SolidWorks. The key aspects of this design that I will focus on are the feature manager design tree organization, dial features, face features, exporting to STL files, and 3D printing. This project is great to practice your multi-body part design, even if you don't make the counter. Let's get started. I created this design as two parts in a single part file using multi-body part or master model technique. I have grouped the features of each body into folders, one for the dial features and one for the face features. At the top of the feature manager tree, the solid bodies folder has two bodies. I'll click and hide the face solid body. Let's take a closer look at the dial. I start with a simple 2-inch circle extruded an eighth of an inch. The next feature is the numbers. I'll edit the sketch and you will notice there is a construction circle acting as a guide curve for the placement of the text. It is offset from the edge of the original boss feature. Dimensioning it this way ensures that the position of the text will always stay this distance from the edge, regardless of the size of the original feature. This is called design intent. I'll double-click one of the numbers to launch the sketch text property manager. The construction circle is the curve. I type the numbers from 0 to 9 with no spaces and chose full justify to position the numbers evenly around the circle. Notice the other buttons I use to orient the text. For the font, I chose Century Gothic Bold. This gives me nice, clean, easy-to-read numbers. For the bumps around the edge, I extruded a small circle the thickness of the original boss and created a circular pattern with an amount that looked good to me. Lastly, I put a 1/4-inch hole in the center. To create the face part, I began by placing the first sketch on the top face of the dial. The sketch that drives this is a multi-contour sketch. Notice the inner circle is offset from the outer circle, which is related to a vertex from one of the bumps. Again, this is design intent, and it takes full advantage of SolidWorks parametric capabilities, and is a key benefit of multi-body part design. Even when I am in this sketch, I can control the visibility of the dial body to see that everything is going to look great. At this point, all I need to do to create a multi-body part is uncheck Merge Result. Taking advantage of multi-body design, the post on the bottom is driven by a sketch circle that is offset from the hole created in the dial body, 2/1000ths of an inch. This provides a small interference fit, allowing the post to snap into the dial. By doing this, I don't need to add any fasteners or tabs to hold the two parts together, which allows the dials to sit nice and flat on the table. The last thing I do is put a few fillets to finish off the design. The small fillet on the post helps to guide the post into the hole. Now that the components are finished, I need to save the individual bodies to a format that my 3D printer will understand, an STL file. For this, I will utilize the Insert into New Part command. Using this method will allow me to create an assembly with the two components and generate the STL files. I'll expand the Solid Bodies folder, right-click a body and choose Insert into New Part from the context menu. Next to Title, I click the button to browse, name, and save the file. Then click the green check to initialize the command. This creates the part file and opens it. Notice the Feature Manager design tree has one feature called Stock with the name of the part file it is derived from, in this case, the Counter Single Master file. With this file open, I'll choose Save As and select STL for the type. If you click the Options button, you can specify options for resolution. Adjustments made here can affect the quality of your prints. I'll click Save and Yes to dismiss the message. Now I will return to the master part and do the same thing with the face. With the face part open, I will click New, Make Assembly from Part, and click the green check to insert the part at the origin. Now I will insert the dial. And since I haven't closed it, it appears in the list, so I'll click to place it in the assembly. I'll position it and rotate it a bit so I can add a peg and hole mate with the Alt key. And now I can see how the assembly will work as I spin the dial. I'll save the assembly and add some appearances. Medium gloss plastic blue for the face and black for the dial, applied at the part level. Followed by white applied to the top surface of the dial. Now I can see how my design will look and behave when it is made. Beautiful! The double dial presents some other challenges, mainly with regards to the orientation of the numbers. In the single dial, the numbers are not rotated at all. They simply follow the circular sketch curve. With a two-dial counter, the numbers are rotated, and with the right dial, the numbers have to be flipped. Let's take a closer look at the right dial. You will notice the numbers are typed from 0 to 9 as before, but there is some syntax surrounding the numbers. These instructions are added when you click the rotate button once. At the beginning of the text string, you can see a lowercase r followed by a number. This is the angle of rotation. Simply change this number until you get the correct orientation. Notice the guide curve is also a little different because these numbers have to be flipped to the opposite side of the curve so the numbers will appear in the windows of the face dial correctly. This particular design is clean and simple. There is no need for support material and as such creates no waste at all. When I am designing anything, I try to keep two things in mind. The capabilities of the manufacturing process, in this case, my specific 3D printer, and the second thing is to create designs that minimize waste, being aware of environmental impact. This is referred to as DFAM, or Design for Additive Manufacturing. The face is printed so the posts are facing up. The dials, of course, numbers up. In this orientation, I am maximizing the accuracy of the hole in the dials and the diameter of the posts. Printing this way gives the cleanest and most accurate circumference of each, ensuring a nice, slight interference fit. Each 3D printer will vary in its accuracy. Watch for a future video where I will show a great method for testing the accuracy of your printer. In my slicer, I can determine exactly where the first layer of the sides of the numbers begin. Here, about 45 minutes. This is the time where I will switch the filament from black to white, providing a wonderful multicolor effect, making the numbers stand out nicely. With the master model technique demonstrated here, any changes made to the master model will transfer to the parts and ultimately be reflected in the assembly. There are many ways to approach any design. I favor this technique for the counter design because the parts fit so nicely together. The design intent of the dial drives the design intent of the face. Only a few dimensions drive the entire model. I could have designed this using top-down assembly modeling as well, but then I would have to deal with the in-place mates that result, and I wanted to see the movement of the dials in relation to the face. For most of my designs, I use multibody part or top-down assembly modeling, and sometimes both. It all depends on the design intent. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned to this channel for upcoming projects in the Useful SOLIDWORKS Design Projects You Can Make playlist. And if you found this content helpful, visit the site below to access more content for designing with SOLIDWORKS.